Hey guys, today we're going to look at the Blade 350 QX3 and the CGO2 camera and gimbal. This quad is designed for aerial photography and video that is insanely smooth, stable, and easy to control. I've used it quite a bit in the last few days that I've had it, and I'll talk about my test flights later in the video. As you will see, this combo kit will get you going with aerial work right out of the box and has everything you need. This one definitely fits a budget, but doesn't lack on the performance end. The kit really is loaded, and it all ships in a box made for transportation, as you would typically expect from Blade. You get a 3-cell, 3000mAh LiPo battery with a charger and power supply, a Spectrum DX4 radio with batteries included, the 350 quad rotor itself, and of course, the CGO2 3-axis integrated gimbal. The stock radio does have all the controls needed to fly the aircraft, including 5 flight modes along with gimbal control. And the incredible camera and gimbal packs a 16 megapixel still image and 1080p 60 frames per second stabilized video. The gimbal mounts with shock absorbing rubber to the main body, which is flown by 4 brushless outrunner motors. Check out this tilt control possible with the stock radio for 5 seconds at a time in flight and unlimited control on the ground. The gimbal totally eliminates pitch and roll of the aircraft in flight, and is programmed with padded yaw correction for the smoothest panning. So, if you're looking to start your hobby or profession in aerial photography or video, continue watching to find out more about this aircraft. And as you can see, this quad is just ready to go. So please enjoy this complimentary sample footage up next, and then we'll look at what it takes to get started. You probably want to keep watching that smooth footage. So do I, but I've saved that for another video. Just look at how easily the quad takes off and stabilizes. I have to admit I have a few years of practice with helicopter controls, but this thing is way easier to fly than I expected. The real skill is in capturing scenes the way you want to, and composing shots from an aerial perspective while on the ground. With automatic GPS locking, the quad will maintain its coordinates and altitude when you center the controls. This will allow you to climb straight up with no problem at all for compelling camera motion. This is also useful for creating those panning shots that have to be locked in and still. Another beloved feature of this machine is its return to home mode. It lands an impressively smooth touchdown every time, however it is often 2 feet away from your takeoff location. Just use precaution if you're in a small area. The camera quality itself is very promising, and you can certainly get that lens flare that you're after. you can see the 1080p results almost look super sharpened, which can sometimes appear like grain. Wide-angle distortion is also a concern, but I've found you can correct this almost perfectly with any software that has GoPro editing presets. Okay, getting this thing off the ground is as simple as it gets. Remove the hatch and you will see a Velcro strap for the battery, the power cables, and the programming wires are tucked beneath the battery compartment. There's not a lot of space inside the model, so you're going to want to tuck the balancing leads around the side once you've fastened the Velcro. Connect your bullet connectors and tuck them in as best you can. Replace the hatch and flip up the GPS mast when you're ready for better reception. Okay, now you're ready to install the gimbal. The kit comes with an 8GB microSD card, which is easy to lose and all too difficult to put in the gimbal, so just be careful and make sure it's in the right direction. Okay, there's just one cable to snap in, which simplifies the whole process. Slide the gimbal on the tracks, plug in the cable, and then lock it into position. Now turn on the radio first and find the switch on the bottom of the quad. Power the quad on and let the system boot up. The model will indicate when it has GPS lock with a solid LED and the color changes according to your current flight mode. The two rear main rotors are illuminated with blue and the front rotors are lit with red. To power on the model, bring both sticks in and down until you hear a tone and center them again. To stop the motors, pull the left stick down and hit throttle cut. You can toggle the throttle and gimbal switch on the top right and the left stick becomes your tilt angle for 5 seconds in flight or unlimited on the ground. I'm going to make a separate video on the 5 flight modes, which will be in the description. But for a brief overview, you have smart mode, aerial photography mode, and return to home. Just pull the right stick toward you and cycle the flight mode switch 4 times to enter the last 2 modes, which are stability mode and agility mode. There's a quick start calibration guide with LED indicator charts to help you interpret any feedback the quad is giving you. With all of this said, I highly recommend the Blade 350 QX family of quads. These will give you professional results on a budget and offer a ton of flying fun as well. It's also the safest RC aircraft that I've flown to date, as most drones are. This is because of the technology packed into the aircraft that ensures you almost can't lose control of it, even as a beginner. For those of you who are experienced pilots, I do caution you to always check your flight mode before takeoff. The smart mode is designed to fly the quad literally in the direction you move the sticks, regardless of its orientation. If you forget you're in this mode, you can easily find yourself needing a replacement GPS antenna mast or some new rotors. I know this was a longer video, but I hope it gave you a clear understanding of what these machines can do for your films and photography on a budget. Please like this video and subscribe if you'd like to be notified when the flight mode videos are available. I'll also be uploading more of that smooth video, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.